If you don't seem to be getting any response from the optional keypad bezel that your CMOR micro is installed in, check the following items. Number one, make sure that the CMOR micro is fully seated in the housing and engaged with the connector. The panel should be flush like this, not like this. Like this, not like this. Number two, if the panel is not flush, then make sure the clamps are installed and fully tightened to draw the bezel into the housing and to compress the rubber gasket to maintain your IP65 rating. Number three, if you're not worried about maintaining the IP65 NEMA rating, you can simply remove the rubber gasket from the CMOR micro. Now the CMOR micro should drop right into place. Number four, make sure the connector cover on the back of the CMOR micro is removed. And finally, number five, make sure the connector is not damaged. You can see this one has a broken piece of plastic in the way. Here's a quick test to see if the bezel is inserted all the way. Apply power, and you should be able to hear the key press beeps on all the keys. If you hear a beep on all the keys, you know it's fully connected. Now that assumes your project hasn't turned that feature off, of course. See the video on how to enable and disable beeps for more information on that. Well, that's all there is to getting your keypad bezel up and running. Be sure to check out the other videos in this series to get the most out of your CMOR micro panel. And as always, please send us any topics you would like to see covered, or any other comments for that matter. We appreciate the feedback.